the host of Wish You Were Here with Eliza Blue. Now, for the last few seasons and in our upcoming season of the show, we have been sharing stories and songs from the wild, wild Western prairie, specifically stories that document our particular arts and culture scene up here on the Northern Plains. And of course, we would be remiss not to include food on our show. So in this new season, we are going to be taking you to several different producers, specifically in the state of South Dakota. But I thought it might be kind of fun to talk about some people who are making great food right now, if you are interested in including local foodstuffs in your holiday feasting. So I've got a couple of different things to share, but I'm going to add that I would love to learn more. So if you have additional places you think that we should be, that people watching and listening should know about, then please include them in the comments. We would love to learn more. I'm going to start off, though, with a bread company that's based in Sioux Falls. They're called Breadico. I discovered them on a trip to Sioux Falls. I ate bread at someone's house, and it was like the best bread I'd ever eaten. And I said, where did this come from? Anyway, it was a thrill to discover that this bakery, it's a sourdough bread company in Sioux Falls. And you can now also buy it West River. They have it at Bread Root Food Co-op. So I actually used it. I mean, it's great. Just you can have that on your holiday table or, you know, for leftovers to make sandwiches. But I actually love it for making your stuffing. So it's just got a great texture. It holds up really well to all the things that you might want to add. I just toasted. I threw mine in the oven on a baking sheet and toasted it and then cut it up and made it with sort of the standard stuffing recipe that we always use with bacon and apples and sage. So another one that's a little bit unusual, this is an acorn squash. Now, if you have a local producer that you already love to work with, it may be that they have winter squash still available. And you can also find it, you know, in the supermarket or in your local co-op because these keep so well. So this is also just a great way to, if there's a vegetable farm in your area, this is a great way to support them through the winter months when obviously they're not going to be growing new food. So the things that store well, they may still have in stock. So I got some winter squash this year from Cycle Farm, so I'm going to be talking about more. But there's, if you go to, again, any place is probably going to have winter squash. There's a lot of different varieties. Here's just two. This is acorn squash. Butternut squash is another really common one. So this year I actually experimented with making my pumpkin pie with winter squash instead of pumpkin pie. So this was made with acorn squash, and you can see I overcooked it a little bit, but it was still delicious. And the look at the color on that. I mean, it is so bright when I was mixing it up. So I roast my squash, bake it down. It's going to be a little bit more watery than what you get from a can. And obviously it adds this extra step in there. So it's a little bit more work, but I honestly think it's worth it. And I would say also do, I preferred this acorn squash to pumpkin. I think it has a sweeter taste. And I think there are some things that, you know, going local is really worth it. And I would say that with winter squash, if you have someone that you like their winter squash, you just can't compare it to what you would get in a can. The flavor is just so bright and awesome. So next I've got some cranberry sauce. I saw a meme yesterday that was about that cranberry sauce is the thing that no one actually eats. You feel like you have to make it for the holiday table, but nobody actually eats it. But I would disagree. I love cranberry sauce, especially using it almost like a jelly on sandwiches the day after. So this year, for something a little different, we were able to get cranberries that are from Wisconsin. So not local, but, you know, not too far. But then I cooked apples down into applesauce. And I also had some choke cherry juice left over from this fall. And I'm not, I used to try to make choke cherry jelly and it never worked. So now I just make choke cherry juice and call it good. And I freeze it. And then I use it, I freeze it in little ice cubes and I add it to all kinds of things during the year. And so I tried that this year with adding apples that I had made, cooked onto applesauce, and choke cherry juice to the cranberry sauce. And oh my gosh, it just, it's so, I swear, it is so good. My kids even eat it. There is one other magic ingredient though. Just that would not be, I don't think, sweet enough. So we added a whole bunch of local honey. Now, up where I live in the northwestern part of South Dakota, we actually have a lot of local honey companies. It's pretty cool because, and also just different ranchers around us will have honey that they, or beekeepers that will come and put hives on their land in this during the summer months. So honey is, we use that a lot as a sweetener because it's just really easy to get and it's so delicious. So this is from a honey company up by us. It's actually in North Dakota, in Headinger, North Dakota. But there's, again, there's a lot. If you do a Google search, you're going to find there's a lot of great options for local honey. Another little baking tip that I've really been thankful for the last couple of years is a company called Bell Valley Ancient Grains. They are based right outside of Belle Fourche, and they create or they grow organic grain, and most of it is heirloom. Well, all of it is heirloom. Some of it is ancient. Some of it is our newer varieties. The one that I've been especially happy with, I guess simply because my kids seem to like it the best for baking, is their Clark's Cream Wheat. It's a hard white winter wheat. So I'm gonna, this is what it looks like. It has just a great flavor, a great texture. This is what it looks like when it's a whole grain. And it's surprisingly light. So if you have, like me, you know, somewhat picky kids, this is very enjoyable to bake with, I think. And I think you'll be happy with the results if you're feeding people that are used to white wheat. If you like whole grains and you are, so you aren't scared to cook with something that's going to have a little more heft to it, they've got a lot of other varieties that are all delicious. Their Red Fife is also excellent. So I a couple of years ago, I got a countertop grain mill. So this is what it looks like. You can see when it's just ground at home and like that, it's, you know, it's a little bit nuttier and, the flakier, I guess, maybe I'm trying to think of a good word to describe it, than you'd get with a milled white wheat. But it's just, yeah, it's a great lighter option. And they do sell it already milled if you don't want to invest in a tabletop grain mill. So I use it almost exclusively as a sourdough, and that's just the preparation I love. And we use it for pizza dough. We use it for bread, we use it for pancakes, and they're all good. So let's see. Oh, next I'm going to bring up one of the, another thing that you can find that's great, again, for supporting somebody who is a diversified vegetable farm and therefore might not have crops that they're selling fresh in the summer, or I mean in the winter, but may still have garlic on. So I got this from Cycle Farms, but I know there are great other options. And again, I just realized one of the other places I didn't mention but should have is Bear Butte Gardens, which is in Sturgis. They have a farm stand that's also open year round, and they carry all kinds of different options. In addition, even to food, they also have other local products. So it's a good place to look for gifts. And then there's the there's a food hub in Sioux Falls called Fresh Foods that we will include a link for, because that's another great option if you don't already have somebody in mind that you can get your produce and your local options from. All right, so let's see. It looks like we've got one more thing. This is kind of an unusual one. But a friend of mine recently made me this chili oil And oh my gosh, it's like world changing. I'm not usually a spicy foods person, but it's so, so good. If you go to my Facebook page, I'm going to include the recipe for this so you can make it at home. It's so good. Now, obviously, we don't usually think of spicy foods as something that we would enjoy during the holidays. Those wouldn't be quote unquote traditional foods. But if you want to spice it up, this is a fun way to do it. And this actually also would make a great gift because it keeps really well and it's just delightful. So again, dried peppers are something you can find this time of year. Here's Cycle Farms. Two options. This one is a little fruity. It's spicy, but also fruity. This is the straight up heat. And just, you know, planning ahead for next year. If you are a home gardener, this is a great thing to do for yourself. Grow some peppers, just hang them to dry in your house. Or I sometimes will lay them out on cookie sheets out in a sunny spot and just, you know, keep turning them, and they dry up really, really nice. And then you can use them in all kinds of preparations all winter long, and it just adds a nice little flavor of summer. So I think that is it for now. Happy feasting. And again, if you have thoughts for us, please include them in the comments. And in January, we're going to be dropping some new episodes for the season. So I will see you then.